Today, we'll learn how to determine the convergence and divergence of the infinite series using the p-series test. First, let me introduce the p-series test. Sum of 1 over n to the power p, as n goes from 1 to infinity, converges if p is greater than 1, and diverges if p is less than or equal to 1. To prove this, we need to utilize the integral test as explained in the previous video. If you haven't watched it yet, I recommend checking the link in the upper right corner to watch the integral test video first. For the proof of the p-series test, let's designate f of x as 1 over x to the power p. When x is greater than or equals to 1, this function is always continuous, decreasing, and all terms are positive. Therefore, since it satisfies all three conditions required for the integral test, we can use the integration to determine the convergence or divergence of the sum of 1 over n to the power p as n goes from 1 to infinity. Now, let's integrate 1 over x to the power p from 1 to infinity. To solve this in proper integration, we'll rewrite the expression using limits. As p approaches to infinity, the expression becomes the limit of the integral of 1 over x to the power p from 1 to p. To simplify the integration, let's rewrite 1 over x to the power p as x to the power of negative p. Upon integration, we get the limit of x to the power of negative p plus 1 over negative p plus 1. Before substituting b and 1 for x, let's simplify minus b plus 1 to 1 minus p. Therefore, as b approaches to infinity, the expression becomes the limit of x to the power of 1 minus p over 1 minus p. The denominator 1 minus p is a constant, so it can be factored out, resulting in the limit of x to the power of 1 minus p as p approaches to infinity. Now, substituting b and 1 for x, we get 1 over 1 minus p times the limit of b to the power of 1 minus p minus 1. This expression seems challenging to find the convergence condition with. So let's express b to the power of 1 minus p as the reciprocal 1 over b to the power of p minus 1, making the expression 1 over 1 minus p times the limit of 1 over b to the power of p minus 1 minus 1. Now, let's examine the expression highlighted in yellow more closely to determine its convergence and divergence condition. What would be the limit of 1 over b to the power of p minus 1 as b approaches infinity? Would it converge or diverge? Let's consider an example. What would be the value of the limit of 1 over b as b approaches to infinity? It is 0. Then, what about the limit of 1 over b to the power of negative 1? As b approaches to infinity, the expression becomes the limit of b, which ultimately tends to infinity. Do you see the difference between these two expressions? When the exponent of the value b in the denominator is positive, it converges to 0. But when the exponent of the b becomes negative, it diverges to infinity. In the end, for the expression to converge, the exponent of b in the denominator, which is p minus 1, must be positive. In other words, for the convergence of this expression, p must be greater than 1. Therefore, 1 over 1 minus p times the limit of 1 over b to the power p minus 1 minus 1 as b approaches to infinity becomes 1 over 1 minus p times negative 1 when p is greater than 1, as 1 over b to the power p minus 1 approaches 0 as b approaches to infinity, ultimately simplifying to 1 over p minus 1. However, when p is less than or equal to 1, it diverges. Shall we consider an example? If the value of p is less than or equal to 1, such as half, then the expression becomes 1 over 1 minus half times limit of 1 over b to the power of half minus 1 minus 1, which simplifies to 2 times limit of 1 over b to the power of negative half minus 1. This expression further simplifies to 2 times limit of b to the power of half minus 1. As b approaches to infinity, this value ultimately diverges to infinity. Let's solve a few simple examples together. How about the infinite series 1 over n to the power of 0.9? Since p is 0.9, which is less than or equal to 1, according to the p-series test, this infinite series diverges. Now, let's consider the infinite sum of 1 over n to the power of 1.001. Upon close inspection, the value p is 1.001, which is greater than 1. Therefore, this infinite series converges. What about the infinite sum of 1 divided by the fifth root of n? The denominator's fifth root can be rewritten as n to the power of 1 over 5 as shown on the screen, right? The p-value would be 1 over 5, which is less than 1. So this infinite series diverges. How about this one? The sum of n to the power of negative 2 over 3 as n goes from 1 to infinity. In this problem, the p-value is 2 over 3, which is also less than 1. Therefore, according to the p-series test, it diverges. Lastly, what about the sum of 3 over n to the power of 4? When we expand the parentheses, it becomes a sum of 81 over n to the power of 4 as n goes from 1 to infinity, indicating that the p-value is 4. Since the p-value is greater than 1, this infinite series converges. How was it? You can apply the p-series test very simply, right? Actually, the problems you need to solve may not always be this straightforward. Utilizing them with a direct comparison test or the limit comparison test, which we will learn in the upcoming videos, can significantly enhance their applicability. I will introduce the direct comparison test and the limit comparison test in detail in the next video. Did you enjoy today's video? If you did, please subscribe and like. Your support means a lot to me. Thank you to everyone who has been watching. I've been your math guardian, Alex.